Right. So let me see today a new chapter called as Requirement Engineering. Requirements Engineering. Under this, we'll discuss functional, non-functional requirements as well as the software requirement document, nothing but SRS, their specification, how the process of engineering can be done with the help of these requirements. As well as the last, these are the phases of requirement engineering. Like we have the framework activities in software engineering. Here as well as the process consisting of the phases like elicitation, analysis, validation, management. All the last three topics will deals with the process. We can say all these four topics will be considered as a whole, right? So without any late, let me start the software requirement. Please make a note the definition of software requirement. Like we have different definitions for software engineering. We have requirements as well for the definition. That is, one requirement is the definition, a condition or capability. The meaning here talks about whenever any requirement has given to the customer, to the developer, from the customer to the developer or from to the stakeholder, that requirement is nothing but if the condition is true, the requirements are satisfied. If the condition is false, the requirements is not satisfying to the customer, isn't it? So requirement indirectly talks about inversely proportional to condition. When the condition true, requirement satisfied. Condition false, requirement not satisfied. So capable, need by a user, user in the sense the customer, to solve a problem or achieve an objective. Achieve an objective means the theme, whatever the theme required to complete a particular task. If it is fulfilled, then it is called as a requirement. So simply, a requirement as per the IEEE standard definition is a condition or capability needed by a user to solve a problem or achieve an object. In another way, we can say a condition or capability thus that must be met or possessed. Met in the sense that has to meet, met or possessed by a system or system component to satisfy the contract. This is to contrast standard specification or formal imposed document is called as software requirement. Okay, so a condition or capable that must met or possessed by a system or a system component. System component in the sense a module into that system that has to satisfy all this, construct the standard specification or formal imposed document. And simply we can call as a third definition, a documented representation of a condition or capability as in one or two. Maybe in any one of the condition, one or two, if your representation will be in the form of a documented, that will be satisfying in that document, the condition if you satisfy or the capability, whatever it is representing in that documentation, it satisfy any one of the condition, maybe first condition or second condition. So indirectly, the definition three said that any one of the definition one and two, right? So simply please remember any one of the definition and please fulfill that definition in the same way in the examination. So coming to the software requirements. So just now we have discussed requirement, the definition of this SR. Now coming to this, it encompasses, means software requirements encompasses both. It talks about the user views as well as developer views. So because when we talk about this as a point of the requirement, as a point of the user's view, it deals with the external view. External view in the sense it is outside. The users will be outside. It look like how your product, how you develop the product, how the product is visible to the end user. That's why it is a external view. And coming to the developer's view, it's a inside the characteristics. The developer always look into the technical view, look into the internal parts of the view. So that's why any software requirement, it look like or encompasses in two ways. One is the user point of, another is developer point. User point always, it is a view of external. The developer always the view of inside. Coming to the first one, the user requirements. So we can call two types of software requirements, or many number of types is there. But as part of this, we'll talk about one by one, right? So if you see here, again, we'll talk in detail of how the requirements will talk about this. So first requirement, user requirements. So how you are collecting the requirements from the customer? That is the first type of requirement, the user's requirement. How you are collecting? The first phase of the framework activity is, first activity is communication. In the communication, directly we are mentioning that gathering the requirements, like we are going to communicating with the customer. So just we are recording in the form of a statements. That statements, not the programming statements, it is a natural language. And plus diagrams, like you have collected the SRS. In that SRS, there is a brief description, what's the theme, problem statement, what is the overview, scope of that one, what are the objectives are there, and some diagrams. Diagrams always, most of you have SRS consisting some use case diagram mostly. Not only that use case, but also we can have a flow diagram, flow chart, and also it describing the services that the system is expecting to provide and the constraints. So these are the three things it is recorded in the user record. The first one is it recorded the statements, the normal statements it is recording. The second, including in the statements, it consisting of diagrams. So that's why we can call as this is 1.1. Okay. The second one is, the second part here is, we can call as describing the services that the system is expected to provide. The third one is required, the constraint. This is the third one. Okay. Coming to the second type of requirement is system requirements. When deals with the users, it is recording. When deals with the system, it describes the system function. That is the first one. The second one, the services. The third one, operational conditions. Because system requirements deals with the internal parts, like how the functionality will works, how the communication between the module to module or component to component inside the architecture. All such type of stuff we are going to discussing in system requirement. That the first one is functions, second one the services, third one the conditions. So it describes the these three. And user requirement, simply it recorded the statements as well as the services as well as the constraints. Okay, so that the two categories of user system requirement, user as well as system. If we talk about the system requirement, again consisting of, we can call as two types. One is functional requirements, and there is non-functional requirement. So system functional requirements, system non-functional requirement. Normally software requirement consisting of two parts, the user, system. Again, system requirement consisting of system functional requirements, system non-functional requirements, FR and FR. Coming to the functional requirements, when we deal with the functionality, it always talks about the internal services it provides, statement of services. Most of you are identified the different projects, and among that projects, you also identify what are the functional requirements for that your respective project, respective SRS, and what are the NFRs for your respective projects, right? Now, let me talk about what actually the functional requirements means. The statement of services the system should provide. We are giving what actually, what are the different functionalities, what are the different outcomes we are expecting from that product. It deals with functionality, that is functional requirement. And also it discusses about the behavior. Now, in the behavior talks about whenever any event trigger for that, how the your product will perform, how the actions will, what are the reaction for from your product. That talks about the behavior. Okay, so it describes the behavior as well. And it defines the system reaction. As I said you, for any trigger of giving of any event, how the reaction of that particular event, what are the action it will perform. So it simply talks about input, process, output. So it deals most probably about the process. So whenever any input gives, how the out, input comes, in between this, a process will be there, right? That process is nothing but here, how that process internally it is performing, the functionality. The functionality will be done between the input and output process is this functional requirements. So it gives the statements of services, what the system will provide. It describes the behavior as well as defines the system reaction for a particular inputs. So that deals with FR. When you come to the NFR, non-functional requirements, it deals with the outside of that the process. Means how the non-functionalities, what are the outside we can be seen, like all the LETs, as I said you earlier as well, which ends with LETs, security, we can call reliability, scalability, like this lot of LETs are there. Let me discuss one by one. The constraints on the services and the functions offered by the system. Constraints in the sense on which condition, by giving an input, the condition, based on which condition the outcome has to come. Based on that condition, whenever any problem comes, like the best example, how scalable your product is. How scalable means you have designed for 50 systems, it supports up to the 50 system your product. How scalable, how we can be extend, if vertically scalable or horizontally scalable, if we are increasing the number of systems, if it is 100, how your system will be performed, how your system will be react for that one. It deals with scalable, right? So whenever a condition appears, for that condition, how your system will tolerate, whether any faults comes or whether any fluctuations in the power or any other technical issues comes, how reliable, how scalable, how fault tolerance, how any fault comes, how it will be tolerable for that. All such step of LETs will be discussed in the NFR, including time constraints, timing constraints, constraints on the development process and standards. So this also has to be considered in NFR. Timing constraints in the sense, the how fast your response will be given, how fast, how long your product will be give some support, how long it will be make live. So what is the time period? Like we are heading about 5-year warranty, 4-year warranty, 2-year warranty. So it depends on the time constraints and the development process constraints as well as standards, how good it is following. Like the standards in the sense, the policies, power policies or any other safety policies, how good they are going to follow. Apply to system as a whole. That also we discuss in NFR. So apply to system as a whole in the sense it deals with the external thing. So that's why most will be considered as NFR. The last step of requirement in the system requirements is domain. The name itself discuss about domain means specific to one. Specific to one, it deals the requirement related to a specific application of the system. Domain in the sense, particular area, particular application. It will be whether application to application, the requirement will change. Yes, application to application, product to product, it will be changed definitely. Because for all sort of products, the same requirement is not suitable. ATM is one requirement, and doing some online shopping is another requirement, and just making a transaction is another requirement. So it is based on the domain, it will vary from one to another, right? So reflect the characteristics and constraints on that system. So these are the third type of the subtype of this system requirement is domain. So first one, system non-functional requirement, system non-functional requirement, and system domain requirements. Clear? Is it, hope you have clear about this. Let me have a small interaction over here in the user requirements. Let me take one small example. We are considering the total two types of software requirements, right? User requirement, the second one is system requirement. Agree? Now, I'm just taking one small example. The MHC PMS shall generate monthly management reports showing the cost of drugs prescribed by each clinic during that month. Drugs in the sense, here the medicines. So MHC PMS is the hospital has to generate monthly management reports. Management reports means how many number of medicine, each medicine, how much the cost, what is the total report of that month, the cost totally, how many number of medicines they sold it. It has to show or use that medicine. What is the cost of that drugs prescribed by each clinic during that month? Each clinic in the sense, like any hospital is maintaining, they are referring. They are showing that they are going to be providing as a dealer there, and what are the different clinics they are going to be taking over there. Now, for different clinics, how they are going to be supplying this, the medicines or drugs to them. So that drugs in the sense here, medicine, how they are going to supply. So totally has to generate a report, and in that report has show the different medicines with respect to cost and total cost. So this is called as the user requirement. So at the end of the user, end user, this is the requirement they are expecting. So as the definition talks about the internal thing, that the internal thing, how the user, if you see the previous, the user requirement deals with a statement, which if requires some diagram, which describes that services, what's the services required? A report that is generated, the cost of that drugs. It has to give a general statement. So the condition here is monthly. Monthly, the condition, each clinic is another condition. So that constraint. So it deals with all. So that is a normal example the statement talks about. The second type of software requirement is system requirement specification. So in this one, it is specifying system. Now it is specifying last working day of each month. The first system requirement is last working day of each month. Maybe sometimes it is a Feb, sometimes it is a March, sometimes it is a April. If it is a Feb, it is a 28 days. If it is a March, it is a 31 days. If it is a April, it is a 30 day. So last working day of each month, maybe it is a which day? Maybe if it is a second, it is a weekend, Saturday, Sunday is not there. If it is a month is 30, 28 is the last day of the working day. A summary of the drugs prescribed, summary of the drugs prescribed in the cell, what type of medicine it is. Maybe say 3 mm or 3 ml or what sort of medicine it is, whether it is a syrup or whether it is a normal medicine or is an injection type of things. There are costs, it has to describe over there. The cost, the prescribing clinics shall be generated. So that is the first system requirement it is talking over here. Okay, the first requirement, system requirement. The second deals with, the system shall automatically generate the report for printing after 5:30 on the last working day of the month. 5:30 in the sense, if the clinic will open up to 5, after 5, that is 5:30, will be generated automatically. The third system requirement is report shall be created for each clinic and shall list the individual drug names, that is drug names, the total number of the prescriptions, the number of doses prescribed, and the total cost of the prescribed drugs. So here it is gives the total overall all clinics. Here each individual clinic they are giving. The fourth sub requirement of the system is if the drugs are available in different dose units, like 10 mg, 20 mg, separate report shall be created for each dose unit. So as this is going to be assessed to all cost reports shall be restricted to authorized users listed on the management access control list. So this list can be viewed by only the restricted peoples, only who have the authorized thing that can be viewable for that. So such type of defining requirements will comes under system. What's the user actually needed? Just a monthly report of the cost of the drugs for each clinic. That is a simple requirement. But to generate that, how the system has to react for that input, how it has to be generated, the outcome, output of that one, that will be discussed internally. Internal part will take care of by the system requirement specification. Okay. So it deals with, it is not software requirement specification, it's a system requirement specification. Software requirement specification is different. System requirement specification is different. We'll talk about that SRS as well. Okay. So this is the one figure which talks about the one MHCPMS report. Okay. Now, coming to the figure over here, the user requirements deals with, if you see the user requirements, it deals with user requirements, deals with client manager, the first one. The second talks about system end users. Third talks about client engineers. Fourth talks about contract managers. Fifth talks about system architects. Client managers, system end users, client engineers, contract managers, system architects. So all these people are going to be involved in this user requirements. Managers, end users, the engineers, and also the contract managers, system architects will be involved here. So readers of different types of requirement specification. So we will be give the inputs for user requirement. These are the five. Coming to the system requirement, system end user will be have the some involvement over here. The second, client engineers. The third one, the system architect. The fourth one, system developers. Okay. So these are the four members who are involved in system requirement. System end users, client engineers, system architects, software developers. Right. So that is a basic intro part of this requirements engineering. That we have just now we have discussed about the definition of software requirement and the different categories of software requirement like user requirements, system requirements, again system requirement consisting functional, non-functional domain. And we have shown one example of MHC PMS and who has to involve or the roles involved in user requirement is client managers and will be involved in the user requirements as well as system end users, client engineers, contract managers, system architects. And system requirements, the involvement will be from end users, client engineers, system architects, as well as software developers. Okay. So that's about the intro part of the requirement engineering. So if you have any doubts, let me see.